Namaskar, welcome to Daradia. We are going to present few educational DVDs where we are going to describe, we are going to demonstrate different interventional pain management procedures. As you all know, most of the interventional pain management procedures are CM guided, X-ray guided. So here we will be describing different related anatomy on the models, we will be describing how we are going to do these procedures, related anatomy, possible complications and indications. So first we are going to describe lumbar sympathetic block, which is one of the very important interventional pain management techniques, and first Dr. Rochak Tater will describe the related anatomy of lumbar sympathetic chain. In most of these procedures, we will be showing you what are the anatomies, what are the indications, what might be the possible complications, and as well as the techniques. When we will be describing the techniques, we will be describing it on the models, mannequins, as well as when we are doing it on the live patients. There will be two pictures, one taken from the X-ray, because all of these procedures are mostly X-ray guided, CM guided, as well as some pictures are taken from the real patients, how we are to show how we are putting this needle and performing these procedures on the patients. So first procedures which we are going to describe here is a lumbar sympathetic block, and Dr. Rochak Tater is going to describe a related anatomy.
Hello, I am Dr. Rochak, and I am going to explain about anatomy of lumbar sympathetic chain. In human body, sympathetic fibers comes from thoracolumbar outflow, that is from T1 to L1 and sometimes from L2. There are two lumbar sympathetic chains situated over the anterolateral part of the vertebral bodies from L2 to L5. And in the sympathetic chain, there are certain ganglia that are situated, and two of these ganglia are mostly constant in our body. One is at the L2 level and other is at the L3 level. The L2 sympathetic ganglion we always target at the upper 2/3 and the lower 1/3 of the vertebral body at L2, and L3 we always target at the upper 1/3 and lower 2/3 of the vertebral body. For L4 and L5 ganglia, we always target at the middle 1/3 of the vertebral body. In case of leg symptoms, it is L4 which is to be targeted with L2L and L3, and in case of foot symptoms, it is L4 ganglia which is targeted with the L2 and L3. Now I welcome Dr. Palak, and she will tell you about indications of lumbar sympathetic block.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. Palak Mehta, consultant pain specialist at Ahmedabad and also visiting faculty at Daradia Pain Clinic, Kolkata. Today I would like to say something about pain which is related to some lumbar sympathetic chain. There are mainly two types of pain which is related to some lumbar sympathetic chain, that is sympathetic mediated pain, and another is vascular insufficiency related pain. Lumbar sympathetic block is indicated in below mentioned conditions like diabetic neuropathy, postherpetic neuralgia, sympathetic chain involvement due to lumbar or pelvic malignancy, then there is reflex sympathetic dystrophy, phantom limb pain which is neuropathic in origin. Again, it can be also indicated in vascular insufficiency pain like Burgess disease and post-vascular surgery emboli for the relief of the pain. I would like to invite Dr. Gautam Das for again demonstration of the procedures related to lumbar sympathetic block.
So now we are going to describe the procedure of lumbar sympathetic block. As already has been described by Dr. Rochak, that the lumbar sympathetic chain is situated at the anterolateral part of the vertebral body. So our final needle position, so needle tip should be situated at the anterolateral position of the vertebral body. And how to be sure about it? So when we are taking the AP view of the spine, so the needle should just touch or just cross the lateral border of the vertebral body, which I am going to demonstrate here, as well as when we are taking the lateral view, the needle should be touching the anterior border of the vertebral body. So now let us look here. So this is a oblique view. So we can see that this is the vertebral body, this is L3 vertebral body, and we can, it's slightly obliquely rotated, say around 5 to 10 degree. We can see the pedicle nicely here, we can see the end plates, and we can see the transverse process. So what we are doing at this little bit oblique position, the needle is first heated at the transverse process or at just lateral border of the vertebral body, and then we are advancing it so that it's reaching into the anterior part of the vertebral body. And while doing this procedure, every time, so needle should be in contact with the vertebral body. So its needle tip is slightly curved, and we are hitting here, first we are hitting at the transverse process, then we are hitting the vertebral body, and then it should hug. No time, nowhere in this, when we are doing the procedures, this needle should be away from the vertebral body. Because this sympathetic chain is on the vertebral body, so when we will be doing the procedure, so it should walk over the bones of this vertebral body, and ultimately we should reach here. Our needle is advanced, and you can see that here the needle is in the upper part. So when we are doing the procedures at the level of the L3, so normally the needle should stay in the upper part of the vertebral body. And when the needle is ultimately placed, that should be checked by the lateral view as well. This is the AP view of the lumbar spine, and you can see that at the level of the L3 vertebral body, two needles are placed, one from the right side, another from the left side, and these needles are placed in the junction of the lower two-third and the upper one-third. So once we have placed this needle and we are checking by the AP view, we can see the needle tip is just crossing the lateral border. If you try to understand it from this model, that needle should be placed here and lateral most border is here. So if you are placing the needle in the anterolateral border, ultimately when you are checking by the AP view of the X-ray, it should just cross the lateral border of the vertebral body in AP view. Now you have to assess the depth by the lateral view as well. Here the needle is more or less at the junction of the lower two-third and the upper one-third, but you can see the needle has, this is the anterior border of the vertebral body, and needle has crossed. So we have to withdraw a little bit. So we have withdrawn the needle a little bit, and then we have to test it by putting some dye. So we are injecting dye, and you can see the dye is beautifully, it's spreading along longitudinally along the anterior border of the vertebral body, and it's beautifully hugging the anterolateral border of the vertebral body. So this should be checked by the lateral view, as should be, as well as this should be checked by the AP view as well. So now we are checking the dye spread in the AP view as well. So here you can see the needle tip is just crossing the lateral border of the vertebral body in both sides, and you can see the dye spread is along the anterolateral part. So some part is crossing over the lateral margin of the vertebral body, and some part of the dye is along the medial to that of the lateral border of the vertebral body. And as well, you see this dye spread is not very uniform. This is another important feature of the dye spread in lumbar sympathetic block. So both sides the dye has spread was beautiful. So now we can inject the drug. So we can do the, here we have, this was the diagnostic block. So we injected local anesthetic on both the side, but at this position we can do the neurolytic block or we can do the RF block as well in this situation.
Now coming to the complication of lumbar sympathetic block, mainly there are two types of complications. One is procedure related complication and the other is drug related complications. In procedure related complications, mainly they are post procedure backache, injury to the viscera like kidney, ureter, then intravascular, epidural or subarachnoid placement of the drug or dye, And last but not the least is infection or neuritis or injury to the nerves. Then drug-related complications, they are hypotension, paraplegia, genitofemoral neuralgia and retrograde ejaculation of the drug or failure of ejaculation. For this complication, we need to observe the patient for 4 to 6 hours. And we also instruct our patient that if any kind of numbness or weakness or any exaggeration of pain is reported, immediately report to our doctors. Thank you.
We have discussed anatomy of lumbar sympathetic chain, indications for the lumbar sympathetic block, the procedure and its related complications. So the lumbar sympathetic block is a very useful interventional pain management procedures, and it can be used as a diagnostic procedures when we really don't know that pain is mediated sympathetically or not. It can be used therapeutically. Different neurolytic agents are used. Commonest is the radio frequency procedures, but other neurolytic agents like phenol, alcohol can be used to do the lumbar sympathetic block. I hope this audiovisual educational DVD will help you to learn this procedure. But if still you have any question, you can ask us. You can write mail at pain@daradia.com, or you can ask any of your, you can contact any of our faculty members. Thank you very much.